Hello dear students, welcome to Axiomatic Oz. This video is the part of the solution series for IIT JAM 2012. So we are here with this problem 1 of your paper. This problem is an analysis problem and it is totally based on the sequence. Okay, sequence part from the analysis. So let us have a look. Let xn be the sequence. So we have a sequence xn which is given to us in the explicit form, right? Now they are defining this sequence yn like this for all n belongs to natural number. Then the question is asking us about the sequence yn, whether it is monotonic, non-bounded, bounded but not convergent, convergent. So these are your options, right? So now let us begin. Firstly, I will write your sequence xn. What xn is, it is firstly root 1, then minus root 1. Then it's root 2, okay, I should, okay, then it's minus root 2, then it's root 3, then it's minus root 3, and it is keep on going like this, okay. Now, yn is defined like this, x1 plus x2 plus x3 up to how many terms? Up to xn over n for all n belongs to natural. So this is your yn, right? Now suppose try to obtain y1, okay? If you will obtain y1, then what will happen? You will end up with just x1 by 1. So what is x1? It's root 1, right? Now let us try to obtain y2. What is y2? It's x1 plus x2, right? X1 plus x2 by 2. Okay, I should also write things for this. Okay, so now see, what is x1? X1 is this quantity and x2 is this quantity, so you will end up with 0. Are you getting my point or not? So now let us try to write y3. Y3 will be x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3. So now since x1 and x2 are equal and opposite, therefore they will be cancelled out, right? Because it's root 1 and minus root 1. So you will end up with only x3 by 3. So what is x3? It's root 2 by 3. Now let us try to obtain y4. Now let us guess, what is y4? Okay, this will be cancelled by this. This one will be cancelled by this. So you will automatically get 0. So what will be y5? Y5 will be x5 by 5. Okay, this is what you can guess now. So what is y5? X5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will be root 3 by 3. Are you getting my point or not? So if you will obtain y7, what will happen? You will end up with root, it should be 5, okay? You will end up with root 7 by 7. Are you getting my point or not? So let us try to generalize this thing. So yn is actually 0 if n is even, and it's xn by n if n is odd. Are you getting my point now? So this is how we can generalize your yn. Now after this generalization, it will be very much helpful for us, okay? Now let us try to generalize this xn part also, okay? So now see, if we want to get this yn when n is odd, we need this xn, right? So we need to generalize formula for xn when n is odd. So when n is odd, let us check it from here. When n is odd, you have these things, right? So when n is odd, you can easily figure out that it's actually equal to, I should write here that xn is equal to root n plus 1 by 2, and this definition only works for n odd, okay? And we also need that one. All, are you getting my point or not? So this thing can be written as 0 1 by n times of n plus 1 by 2. Are you getting my point? So n even and n odd. Now it will be very much helpful for us to determine whether it converges, it is convergent or not, something like this, right? So, okay, now let us try to evaluate this this limit. Limit n goes to infinity y to n plus 1. What I am doing right now, I am trying to evaluate the limit of, what is this? This is a subsequence of odd. Are you getting my point? This is not a sequence yn. I am working on the subsequence. I am trying to find out the limit for this subsequence. So when n is odd, okay, then what is happening there? So when n is odd, then you will get what? You will get 1 by 2n plus 1. Okay, its limit is also there. And here you will get 2n plus 2 by 2. So you will get root of n plus 1, right? So I should use another symbol, but okay, that's okay. You can easily evaluate this also. So you will end up with 2n plus 1 here and root of n plus 1 over there. So when you will evaluate this limit, just take root n common from it and then just divide it. Okay, you can easily evaluate this limit. You will end up with 0. Okay, try to figure out this limit. Now see what happens. I used a subsequence of odd and figured out that subsequence of odd converges to 0. What I have done right now, I have proved that subsequence of odd converges to 0. Now we already know that if we take a subsequence of even, then what will happen? Okay, if we take a subsequence of even, then what will happen actually? This 0 is a constant number. So for every even number, we get 0. So subsequence of even is constant sequence. Now since it's a constant sequence, and what is that constant number? It's zeros. Thus it converges to 0. Are you getting my point or not? So we have finally proved that subsequence of odd as well as subsequence of even both converges to the same limit point. Okay, now I will just write a result for you. And what is that result? It's a very important result regarding the subsequence of a sequence. Okay, so now let me tell you. So I will state this result for you. If we have a sequence xn, okay, if we have a sequence xn and we have its two subsequence x2n and x2n plus 1, right? Now if these two subsequence both converge to a same number l, then sequence also converges to that limit l. Are you getting my point or not? So what I am using here, I am using that if subsequence of even and subsequence of odd converges to the same limit point, then that limit point converges to the same limit, then that limit is also the limit of the sequence. So this is a very common result in real analysis. I hope you already know this. If you don't know, you have to just remember this result right now. Now we have proved that zero is the limit point, right? For both those, the zero is the limit for both of these subsequences, odd and even. Thus we can say that yn, the sequence yn, converges to 0. Are you getting my point? So that means it's a convergent subsequence. Okay, so now let me just mark correct ones. Now since it's a convergent, that means D is correct. It says not convergent, that is incorrect. B says not bounded, right? Not bound. Now you know that every convergent sequence is a bounded sequence. Okay, convergent means bounded. Therefore, B is also incorrect. Now, first one says whether it is monotonic or not. Now, see, for every real number, for every even number, it becomes 0. And for every odd, it becomes some number. That means it's oscillating sequence. Are you getting my point or not? Okay, so let us draw something like this. Suppose it's even, then odd, even, then odd. What is happening there? It's becoming zero and then going up. It's becoming zero, then it is going up. It's becoming zero, then it is going up. Are you getting my point or not? So this is what is happening with your sequence. Therefore, it cannot be monotonic because it is increasing, decreasing, increasing, decreasing. Okay, so that's how we proved that D option is correct. Okay, so thank you.